This video shows how to use and maintain the ink collector kit on the HP Latex 3000 printer. Use the ink collector kit for porous substrates such as textile banners, flags, or mesh PVC banners. Before installing the HP Latex 3000 ink collector kit for the first time, it's necessary to prepare the printer. If the Install Ink Collector button is not present in the printer internal print server, or IPS, you must download the latest firmware, IPS, and print care releases, which are all available at hp.com. There is a high risk of a printhead crash if you use the ink collector with firmware and IPS released before the end of June 2014. The installation of an additional tube is recommended to protect the open port of the aerosol filter pressure sensor. Move the carriage to the service position and open the front door. Place one tube in each aerosol filter sensor on the high position. Place the new tie wrap at the end holding the tubing and cable together. The new tie wrap should be placed after the existing tie wrap. Be careful that it is not too tight. Cut the excess material off of the tie wrap. Adding the forklift holders is required before proceeding with the installation. Secure each forklift holder under each forklift's support by inserting the two bolts. Secure the two bolts with the two cotter pins provided. This step is only required if the locator is not installed in the printer. The locator goes on the left side of the OMAS, under the left wheel of the ninth platen, counting from the IPS side of the printer. Remove the diverter wheel. Remove the two screws. Install the locator using the same screws that you removed from the diverter wheel. Install the ink collector and the protector before loading a substrate roll. Click the Install Ink Collector button in the IPS screen. A window will open showing detailed instructions for your reference. Click the Raise Carriage Beam to Install Position button to prepare for installation. Make sure that the module latches are open. Turn them to the left if they are not already. Open the front door. Beginning at the front, on the IPS side, install the first collector module. Insert the first module into the guide. Slide the module to the middle until it contacts the locator. Insert all the ink collector modules on either side of the central collector module. Attach each collector module inserted to a module that is already in place. Go to the back of the printer, lower the pinch wheel latches, and pull down the pinch wheel module to its lowest position. Close the latches of all modules. Make sure all the ink collector modules are aligned with each other and that there are no gaps between them. Check that the foams fit into the spaces provided for them. Lift the pinch wheel module and close the latches. Place the rolled protector on the curing module. Do not open the curing module yet. Place the tab of the protector into the slot. The back side should be face up. Unlock the curing module latches and open the curing module. Drop the protector through the gap under the curing module. Insert the barriers at the edges of the protector tab. For 126-inch or 3.2-meter substrates, the barriers are not required. Close the curing module and lock the latches. Hook the clips from the protector to the bottom part of the printer. Install the substrate edge holders only if the substrate requires it. Correctly positioned edge holders help prevent carriage jams. However, incorrectly positioned edge holders could severely damage the printheads and the carriage. Close the front door. Click Finish to complete the ink collector installation. When the installation successful message appears, click OK to continue. Click OK again. Now we will demonstrate how to uninstall the ink collector and protector. Go to the internal print server and click the Uninstall Ink Collector button. Click the Raise Carriage Beam to Install Position button to begin uninstalling the ink collector. Open the front door. Unlock the latches and open the curing module. Remove the barriers and substrate edge holders, if used, from each side. Unhook the four clips from the bottom. Remove the protector tab from the slot. Let the protector slide down softly and remove it from the bottom of the printer. Close the curing module and lock the latches. Check that nothing is dirty or broken. If dirty, clean with a lint-free cloth moistened with isopropyl or VOC-certified cleaner. Be sure to wear gloves to protect your hands. Roll up the protector with the red side out and the black side facing in, starting on the side of the clips. Place the protector in the packaging and store it. Go to the back of the printer, unlock the pinch wheel latches, and lower the pinch wheel module. Open the three latches on each ink collector module. Return to the front of the printer and remove the ink collector modules. Close the front door. Go to the back of the printer. Lift and close the pinch wheel module, then lock the pinch wheel latches. Click Finish on the IPS to complete the removal process. Click OK to continue when you see the Uninstallation Successful message. Click OK again. Refer to the user guide for more details about the ink collector maintenance tasks. Use a lint-free cloth dampened with isopropyl alcohol or a VOC-certified cleaner for the different maintenance steps. Clean the aerosol filters after every 7 liters of ink consumed. Print Care will trigger the maintenance notification. Move the carriage to the service position and open the front door. Open the latch on the left side of each aerosol filter module and then open the lids. Remove both aerosol filters using their handles. Use a flat screwdriver to remove the dry aerosol filter and then a brush to remove any remaining dirt. Try to avoid loose dirt falling into the filter. Reinsert both filters. There is only one way to insert them. If you feel resistance, try to insert the filter the other way round. Close the lids, the latches, and the service position window. Clean the top of the protector and the ribs of the ink collector modules at the end of each roll. Open the front door and the curing module. Wipe the visible part of the protector. Use gloves to protect your hands. Close the curing module and the latches. Wipe the ribs of the ink collector modules. Several maintenance tasks need to be performed after uninstalling the ink collector. First, clean the aerosol filter as previously shown. Next, clean the protector. While you have the protector out of the printer, wipe all surfaces and check the ribs. Clean the ink collector modules. While you have the ink collector modules out of the printer, wipe all dirty surfaces. If necessary, replace the foams. Clean the curing lip, the bottom plate, and the diverter interwheels. With the curing module opened, wipe the curing lip. Wipe the bottom plate and the diverter interwheels. Clean the print zone and the substrate advanced sensor. Clean the print platen. Refer to the Cleaning the Substrate Advanced Sensor on the HP Latex 3000 printer video on the HP Video Gallery for more details. Replace the ink collector foams after every 34 liters of ink consumed. Print Care will trigger the maintenance alert. Slide out the dirty old foams and clean the surface of the ink collector module. Slide in the new foams. You can find additional helpful videos at hp.com/support videos and on our YouTube channel, youtube.com/HP Support Advanced.